Alright guys, Noah and I are back.
We are back.
I am updating the graphic. We have Gabriel, Bibbs on the right playing Elves.
Bibbs.
And we have Kazu Negri on... Oh, excuse me. Gabe is on the left. Kazu is on the right. He's playing Abzan Company. It has been a long day.
Both of these decks can be fast. Pretty fast.
Okay, so who do you like in this matchup, Noah?
Thinking about it, I think it just depends on who has, like, the Elves deck can have the degenerate hand where they just win the game.
Yep.
But their hands also sometimes just are fair. And I think if both players have a fair hand, I think the Coco deck is slightly edged. But I think also that it's more likely that the Elves list has the more unfair hand more often. So I don't know. I think I'm gonna go ahead and go with Elves here. There are some key things that, like, the Elves deck is missing that he doesn't have that some other Elves deck plays that would be great here. The Lord that gives Forest Walk would be extremely relevant.
Elves Champion
would be a card in this matchup that would be insane, and I would think I would snap give it to the Elves player.
I'm with you. I agree with everything you say. Game one, I think I like Elves.
Yeah.
If neither of them has a particularly good hand and it goes long, I like Coco.
Yeah.
Post board we'll discuss after that, but both players with a good hand and causes on the play.
I think so.
Well, even on the draw, like I think I like Elves game one.
I think I do.
All right, so let's sit back and watch. No, I just want to say I've had a great time today with you. It's been a long day, but I've had a ton of fun.
I appreciate it, and so did I. We've been here all day.
All day. And let's settle in and enjoy this last match.
Yeah, this should be a good one. Hopefully they both keep their seven and we just have a great game.
Yeah, it looks like they
have. Sweet.
Perfect. And Kazu with Verticat comes. No bird. Kick it back to Gabe.
Watch this fair Forest play here.
Elvish Mystic.
The most fair.
We've got some shortcutting.
The most fair, innocent play you can see is just a...
These
Forest
are
Mystic.
Green decks.
Yeah.
Green decks there's with mana dorks.
There's nothing degenerate with green
decks.
No,
there's nothing here. All right, we got a turn two Anafenza. He's fetching and shocking.
I would say he is.
I didn't even catch what that fetch is.
Well, he's just...
Nope.
He's
okay, so he's 18.
Points.
All right. So we're looking at a turn four combo from Kazu possibly... That's
Ooh, that could be explosive. That's good. Archdruid on turn two is strong, but...
What did he reveal to the Gilly Palace?
Oh, Gilly Palace, he revealed the Archdruid.
Okay.
Kazu could just have the combo.
Yeah, no, that's why I said he could have a turn four.
Like I said, these both decks are fast.
Yeah, they are fast. And this is a good start from Elves, but... It's not like a Heritage Druid start.
And the problem with Elves is it doesn't have a whole lot of interaction.
Yeah, but, I mean, Gabe gets to untap with a... He could go crazy on this third turn,
Like, I think this will be the turn where Gabe just plays a lot of stuff, and then Kazu has to just win the game or just succumb to the power that Elves generates so quickly.
Right.
And so efficiently. It looks like he has a Nettle Sentinel, Dwinden's Elitist, a Land of War Elves... A Shaman of the Pact, and then two cards I cannot see currently. So he can just go nuts here.
Okay,
and
so
he's going to.
Winan's Elite, he gets his token. The return of Beaver Warrior.
And I think a Land of War Wells would come down. No, probably a Nell Sentinel.
Play a one drop and then activate. So okay, no, he's going to do it now.
He has Shaman of the Pact, Nell Sentinel, Cord, Land of War Elf.
And Kazu could combo next turn. This
is
crazy.
Yeah. They're both doing gross things, but one deck just might be faster than the other.
Every match we have with Gabe has just been awesome.
Yeah.
Oh!
Yikes.
That's brutal. How much is that? He's down to 13. That was 7.
And he can cord for 2?
Yeah. He can cord for 2.
But
we won the game too, just like that.
Both players, Gabriel was going to win the game next turn.
Oh, that was.
But Kazu just had it.
That was insane. Every game with Gabe, it's just great. This elf deck is awesome. Even when it loses, that was
Kazu had the combo there, right?
Yeah, was he conceded to the cord because Kazu could core or for Viserys here, infinite life. Elves cannot deal an arbitrarily large amount of damage. They can do a lot of damage, but not, you know, if Kazu goes to a million, they can't do that much.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so go ahead and give us Gabe's sideboard for the third time.
Yeah, Gabe. Yeah, he. Oh, good players show up often.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So his sideboard is 2 to rest, 2 stay in the mine, 2 reclamation sage, 2 scavenging use, 2 kitchen thinks, 2 dismember, 1 Malira, 2 fracture and gust. So I think the key cards here are scavenging use and dismember.
I would agree.
Yeah, I think there's
no, like, if he could use Stay in the Mind to get rid of the combo, but I mean, I could see him doing it, but I'm not going to say he will.
Yeah, yeah.
But I agree. With Scavenging Ooze and Dismember are definitely, I think, his 2 best options.
Yeah, definitely the key cards.
On Kazu's side, we have 2 Sin Collectors, 2 Tide Hollow Scholars, an Orzhov Pontiff, Kasali Pride Mage, 2 Abrupt Decays, Eidolon of the Rhetoric, Kentucky War's Wage, 3 Path to Exiles, 1 Scavenging Ooze, 1 Revoker. I like Revoker, Pontiff, Path to Exiles, maybe the Abrupt Decay, and the Eidolon of Rhetoric.
Yeah, that Pontiff is going to be sweet.
Pontiff is probably his, if not his best card, it's close. The Rhetoric is really good, and he gets to trim on some of his silver bullets here in the main to just kind of. He already has 1 Pontiff in the main, so he gets to go up to 2.
Yeah, one problem with the Pontiff, though, is at any point that he just has a Lord in play, the Pontiff doesn't do anything.
So, but he's also bringing in, he'll most likely also bring in these removal spells. So, I think post-board, in terms of role assessment, I'm going to put Kazu on the control deck.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it gives us the aggro deck. Look at that Beaver Warrior.
He's such a man. Beaver Warrior, man.
Such a man.
When that Beaver Warrior comes into play, he says, your move.
He's got 1,000 power!
Yeah.
Beat 1,000 power. Alright, so that's the sideboard.
Will.
Let's get a look at our players. These are our finalists, Gabe and Kazu. They've both played a hell of a day of Magic. Kazu winning the standard portion yesterday, potentially
and going to be... being in the finals of the modern portion today.
I know he wants this. He wants to be a 3-time state champion and a back-to-back in the same weekend state champion.
We would never hear the end of it.
I'll be honest, I'd love to see him take this. I would love to see Elves get this. Yeah, like, Gabe is a really nice guy.
Like, I want to cheer for the local player here, but the... every time Gabriel Bibbs has been on camera, he's just been doing great. We had a discussion with him. He seemed like a great guy, just all around.
All of my favorite matches, in addition to the last one with Brandon Kazu, have been Gabe's.
Yeah.
Like,
they've been too much fun.
Yeah.
He's been doing just gross things. Even though he didn't win that game, he was just going to win the next turn.
Yeah.
Like, if Kazu didn't win on that turn 4, Gabe was going to win on his turn 4.
I have my... Modern excites me because of these Quarter of Calling and Company decks.
Yep.
These are what I love. I want to give a shout out to Abe Corson sitting there next to Kazu. He's our head judge. He's a level 3. He's a great guy. I want to say thanks.
Yep.
We could not run these great events without him.
Amazing guy, amazing mentor, amazing judge.
Yeah, I've never met a judge so professional and so consistent.
Yeah. I wouldn't have passed my L1 test if I didn't have Abe.
Yeah.
So.
He's a great guy. I can't say enough about him. Let's go back down into the game.
It looks like Kazu's mulliganing and Gabriel kept his hand?
Kept a 7. So, Gabe keeping 7 on the play.
Terrifying.
I think we're going to... I'd like to see a third game.
Oh, I want to see
a third game. Whoever gets it in the end, I want 3 games. If Kazu gets it in 2, we will go back down and demand a 3rd.
Although the players might be a little too tired for that.
Yeah, I mean, we should probably the results be.
Yeah.
53 viewers. Players. Yeah. All right. Thank you, viewers. Twitch viewers. We appreciate it. Once again, I am Ryan O'Loughlin. This is Noah Porter.
Hello.
This is the StarCityGames.com State and Provincial Championships Modern West Virginia. We are in Forsman Comics and Gaming in Morgantown, West Virginia.
So, turn 1, Cavern of Souls, Land War Elf. Pretty fair. Naming Elves. Turn 2... played the Gitleaf Palace, is that what it is? Revealing the Archdruid, playing Archdruid, so we have the same exact play. Let's see if he has that same explosive turn. And in this case, I'm saying we're probably going to get a game.
Yeah, I'm going Elk. I mean, you can never count Kazu out.
Yeah,
but.
No, never. We've seen points in games where literally we thought there was just like all hope seemed lost for Kazu and just won.
Yeah, Wall of Roots in the Noble Hierarchy.
Jeez!
That's a powerful play, but, yeah. I mean... He's not really any nearer to a combo.
Yeah. Let's see what Gabe has here.
I mean, he can cord for a lot on the next turn.
He can do a lot here.
Yeah.
He can generate so much mana.
I mean, Kazu can cord for a lot on his next turn.
Absolutely.
Gabe could do anything.
Yeah.
I don't...
It's being real fair just playing a Shaman
Impact 3. Okay. Kazu down to 16.
Oh, the scavenging is in his play, though.
Okay, that's... Does he have a green up?
He has a green, or else.
He has a green up. All right.
What do you think about tapping the land or else for mana, casting the Shaman, and leaving the land up for...
Yeah, because he could have Pontiff or another removal spell. Yeah. Gabe has been playing all day long.
Yeah.
All right, so we have Anafenza. So that's one of three. Spell Sky for some protection.
Kazu, would you...
Both the trigger.
Both these players just having the hands.
I love these green decks. They just... They do everything I want to do in this format.
Dismember.
And there's Dismember it with Spellskite on the stack. Kill the Anafenza.
Both players just said, all right, my hand's good. My hand's good. Let's go.
And he paid 4 life for that, I believe.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He paid the tax.
That die needs to be updated, but we'll keep track of life here. We got it. I believe
both players just have... Sweet hands.
I believe Abe is keeping track of their life totals on pad.
Yes, yeah. I would assume.
All right, so we will stay accurate with our life totals as well.
Final match of the States.
All right, he's all in.
Coming at you.
All right, so Wall of Roots blocks Shaman. Spellskite blocks Skooze, who's a 2/2 at the moment.
It could get bigger.
Yeah, there's an Anafenza in the graveyard, so he could go to 3/3, but he can't get big enough to kill the...
The fact that he attacks with the Archer, too, just shows that he doesn't have much going on else in his hand.
Right.
Yep.
Okay, so Kazu's down to 12 from that attack.
But it's not something bad.
Yeah, he falls up with another Skooze. Like, we were right on Scavenging Ooze and Dismember there.
Scavenging Ooze and Dismember are the cards that matter.
He's doing a good job trying to prevent Kazu from comboing off.
His opening hand must have looked at Mana Dork, Archdruid, Scavenging his Dismember. I was like, yes.
Mm-hmm. Gabe is an accomplished player too. He mentioned to us that he played this at the Invitational last weekend.
Yep.
So I mean, he qualified for an Invitational and he got to play this deck at it. Alright, so gain one up to 17 from the Scavenging Ooze.
He also said that he recently added black to the deck.
Yeah. Did he say, was the Invitational the first time he played with the black?
First time he played with the black, he said he wanted to give it another go.
Yeah. I wish we could have gotten more interviews with players. That's great.
I'm thinking he's going to keep that black mana.
The Shaman seems great.
Yep.
It makes you wonder why they never didn't play the Shaman. And Guiltleaf Palace is such an unfair dual land to play with.
It's so powerful.
I'm going to reveal this lord, all right, and then I'm going to play it.
Yeah. Same effect of Wunderwine Hub.
Yeah, Wunderwine Hub with Merfolk.
Although, Guiltleaf Palace is, I would say, better in this deck than Wunderwine Hub is in Merfolk.
Yeah, I would agree, because it makes better use of the Black Splash than Merfolk does with the White Splash. Because it's really just for, like, Path to Exile. Yeah. It's an anti-choke card. It gives them Path and some hateful sideboard cards. Mm-hmm. All right, so Gabe in the tank, going to combat, swing with the team minus the Lord.
He must have drawn something, or maybe he's just...
Maybe he's just attacking.
He wants to protect that Lord.
He does have...
He could cord in response.
He has cord. He has cord mana up. He has company mana up. Scavenging Ooze mana up. It's really hard to tell. Did he play a land yet?
Gabriel? No, he played a land last.
So he could play, like, a Nykthos and then something.
Yes. Something ridiculous.
This deck is crazy.
Makes you really want to build it.
Yeah.
Like, you just watch this deck and you're like, why don't I have those cards?
I had most of this deck at one point.
Yeah? I think I have Visionaries.
I have Visionaries too.
We have War Elves and Elvish Mystics.
Alright, so activate Gavany Township. That ability's on the stack. I think this is before blocks? Yep. Okay, so the two different counters on the Wall Roots. One is a -0/-0 counter for its ability, and then there's also the +1/+1s from the township.
-0/-1.
It's minus O, minus zero, because it affects the
toughness. Yeah.
Okay, so... Okay, so Kazu is down to 4 from that attack. I think we're right. I think we're going to see a game 3 here. But
yeah, I hope we see a game 3. I hope, like, even though it would be awesome if just Kazu just wins the game out of nowhere.
We're still at the end of Gabe's turn? No, he untapped. Okay. I was going to say, if we're at the end of
Gabe's turn, there's something ridiculous that could be happening.
Yeah.
But Noble Hierarch untapped, so...
I was going to say, if it was into Gabe's turn, he could go cord for one piece and then untap and company and get the other.
73 viewers.
All right. Thank you, everyone, for watching.
We're in the final match. Kazu's up a game, but he's at 3 life. We'll see where he...
Viserys here, there's 1. Malira, that's 2. Is that last...
Is that a cord?
Cord. He could cord... He has enough to cord for it.
But there's a scavenging user.
There is a scavenging user play. You're correct.
It matters so much.
It does. It really does. this is nuts. He may be dead on this swing.
You know what would be really good here?
Elvis champion. Yeah, that's good. He does not have it in his list.
No, it is not in his list.
I feel like I would want to play it as a one of.
I think so too. Just as a
cord target. Kapow!
It helps your mirror so like it helps like these Malira matchups so much.
Mm-hmm. For sure.
I would assume so. I mean, I played it. Hello, Ryan.
Yeah, Raven Clay. That is Ryan Wolf, one of our judges. Hi, Ryan. We are in a really intense game 2 here.
Crazy.
In the finals. It's
crazy intense.
I love both these decks.
I love watching Elves play, and I love watching the Abzan Coco deck play.
Yeah, it's... Green is where it's at in modern.
Yeah, Skooz is making this game... is the card on the board that Kazu is...
For all we know, like, this game could be over right now if it weren't for the Skooz. We don't know what Kazu's hand is.
Yeah, exactly.
If he has a cord and weren't for the Skooz, it could just be over. And we may see Kazu untap, like, kill the Skooz, and then cord and win.
Yeah, you never know. And, he's attacking.
I think Gabe is trying to figure out if he can win in a combat step this turn, or if he should... Wait for some for a better attack. If he had, he needs a shaman in the pack. If he had a cord for a shaman,
he could just. Well, we're seeing an attack here.
Yeah, I mean,
well, he hasn't declared yet. I suppose, but
yeah,
we'll see.
I think he's still thinking about it.
Attacking with, you gotta be scared attacking with that scavenging use.
Yeah, I mean that's
you have to be worried.
Yeah, but also in the same, Kazu's at 3. He can't afford to play defense because if he gives Kazu enough time, he's gonna have the combo.
Yep.
Okay, so that's... I believe the black counters are the +1/+1 counters of the Wall of Roots. So he's putting 3 damage on the Scavenging Ooze.
He is putting 3 damage onto it. So
Malira dies. He's gonna... He did not sack it to the... No, it just dies. It just dies in combat. He did not sack it to the Viserys here. Kazu untaps and draws.
Does Kazu play Pontiff? Yes.
Yes, he does.
He has 1 in the main, 1 in the side, and we assume he sided.
We assume he has 2 in his deck right now.
But a Pontiff wouldn't be great here. Sharpshooter's in play.
Yep. He needs to path or Abrupt Decay the Archdruid. Well, if he had that, he'd probably just kill the Skooz. Yeah. And that's assuming if he has, like, a cord or something.
Yeah, we are unaware of the cards in each player's hand.
They are both doing their best to...
Keep us in suspense.
Which is fine. This is great.
What was that card just played? I'm not sure. It went to the graveyard.
It went straight to his graveyard.
Went right to the bin.
You want me to check on that one?
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
All right. On top of Kazu's graveyard.
All right, guys. We gotta find out what that card is as soon as possible, just so we can let you guys know, and we also just really want to know, so. He's gonna check real quick, find out what it is, and come right back up.
He just cycled the Horizon Canopy.
Oh, okay, so what he played was, he played the Horizon Canopy and cycled it.
He had already played it, he just cycled it. We were so busy talking, we just weren't paying attention.
Okay, and they filled us in too.
Yeah. Noah and I are really excited about this.
We just missed it. We just wanted to watch the game.
He drew a card! What did he do? All right. Here's a play.
Where's our Pontiff?
Where's our Pontiff? All right. I have -1/-1 on Gabe's team, we think. Oh, he's sacking it to Viserys here.
Haunt?
To get the haunt.
Yeah.
And then he gets to sack the creature it haunts to give them -2/-2.
Jeez.
Haunt in the finals of the West Virginia State Championships.
Pontiff.
All right, let's bring up Pontiff.
Absolutely. Well, he's doing some things. Kazu's resolving his scry, putting it on bottom, and passing the priority. He's exiling Malira, gaining life, putting a counter on Scavenging Ooze, exiling another card, untapping. Oh, Haunt?
Okay, so I guess that didn't work the way we were thinking it was going to.
What ended up happening there?
I'm not sure.
When it comes... did he just play it to scry?
I suppose he did.
I mean, I guess he's just trying to find a way to...
Well, he could have cast it, given Gabe's team -1/-1, and then sacked it to the Viserys here and, like, haunted the Noble Hierarch.
Yep.
And then sacked the Noble Hierarch to the Viserys here to give them -1/-1 again, correct?
Yep. I'm not sure. He tapped Forest, Gavinny, Godless. He tapped Forest, Gavinny, Godless.
To one, yeah, he didn't pay white and black for the Pontiff?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, go.
Alright,
go on. Guys, we're letting them know that immediately. Oh, that might just make the game. That might make the game.
Twitch chat strikes again.
That might make the game.
Yeah, Twitch chat strikes again.
That might just mean the game.
Abe is taking care of it. We'll see.
That just means that no, he can block three creatures. That just means the game.
So what happened? All right, we'll send one of us back down again to see how this is resolved.
But this could just mean the game. If he has to tap down that knight, if he has to tap down that noble hierarch.
He can't. Black off the godless, white off the noble. Yeah, yeah. You're right.
If he has to do that, if that's the decision that Abe decides to, looks like it's been resolved already. Too much time has passed.
He may say it's not something that's fixed. If Gabe. Or it looks like Abe's still working on it.
Abe,
I should have just stayed down there.
It's crazy, because if this happens the way it is, he just loses. If he has to tap the noble, it's just game over.
Yeah. Pro show. Alright, we'll give them a minute to fix this before we send somebody down to figure out what's going on.
Absolutely.
Yeah, Colonel Excalibur, I believe a beheading is a little extreme in this situation. Yeah.
And if that happens this way, I mean...
And he scryed off the sacking... This is messy. I think they're rewinding.
Gabe determined that not a whole lot has happened since that it's a rewindable game state that they can actually go back and fix what has happened, because has occurred.
They took the card off the bottom that he scryed to the bottom, put it back on top.
Yep.
They untap the mana and put it back in his hand. He's probably getting a warning for this.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure he hasn't had enough warnings for it to result in
so
a game loss.
So Abe's a level 3 judge, and if he finds something that is even more rewindable, he will. But as a judge, I know for a fact that he says he often prefers to leave games as is.
But he found this one rewindable, and Noah and I are both level 1 judges, so we love seeing that kind of stuff. But everything was fixable, so that's what they're doing. I am assuming Kazu will receive a warning. We will confirm all that for you later.
Yep. Crazy.
All right, so he's casting it off the... But now couldn't he possibly do that play that we talked about?
Yeah.
But if he sees it, unless there's something we're not seeing.
Yeah, we could just be dumb.
Yeah, we've been dumb before.
Yeah, we have made made silly, silly goofball mistake. Oh, he drew a collected company was the card in his hand.
Gabe drew a collected company.
Yep, that was the card that
he drew. I think we're going to game three.
Yeah, we're getting another game at least.
Yeah.
So it was rewindable in the sense that the Noble Hierarch should be tapped, but he is not exactly dead because of the Pontiff of Blight will remain in play this time around.
Yeah. West Virginia law does prohibit capital punishment. We do have not have it in West Virginia. So there you go, Colonel Excalibur.
If this was,
we'll drag him to Texas, though.
If this was Yu-Gi-Oh, he would definitely be banished to the Shadow Realm. But I can guarantee you,
Yu-Gi-Boy, that
would have happened if Beaver Warrior was currently in play.
Beaver Warrior, Kazu would be dead.
Yeah.
Beaver Warrior would have already finished Game 3, and we'd be handing Gabe his trophy.
Yeah, Beaver Warrior.
Beaver Warrior.
MVP of the Magic Tournament.
MVP of the Magic Tournament and winning Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournament since 1996.
I don't think Beaver Warrior is a good Yu-Gi-Oh! Card.
Probably not. I don't know. I don't even think Dark Magician is a good...
Tell you that for a fact.
All right. Okay, so looks like...
Did he just exile Canopy with Skooze and gain life off of it? Because that doesn't work that way either. No, he had exiled... the creatures that were in his graveyard and put counters on, I do believe.
And I think this is game anyway. Yeah, we're going to game three. All right,
we're getting to game three. You want to go down there? Or I can go down there.
Yeah, you go ahead. I'll update. Yeah. Exactly. We'll tell you guys the exact ruling while I update the graphic. I'm really happy we're going to a game three here. Super excited. Auroch Stampede, a crazy gas bag. My first Magic deck was mono green Aurochs. Actually, it was the green-red Cold Snap deck Aurochs, and then I remade it to be mono-green because who needs red? But yeah, I'm all about the Aurochs. Great. Do updating the graphic for you guys. If you are just tuning in now, this is the finals of the StarCityGames.com West Virginia Modern Championships. I'm Ryan O'Loughlin. I'm here with Noah Porter, who's getting an update from our head judge Abe Corson on a ruling that was just made during game two of the finals. Our players, Gabriel Bibbs on Elves and Kazu Negri on Abzan Company, are shuffling up for game three and doing any last sideboarding for this final game of our event. That's Gabe there on the left and Kazu on the right. If you're just now turning in, we're up to 76 viewers. Thanks for everybody who's coming in. You see Abe sitting there next to Kazu. And Noah is getting an update from him. A couple local players, Alan Schenk and Brian Huffman, hanging out in the back, watching their friend Kazu do battle. Crazy Zora, you got your first deck today and won your first game. Congratulations. What was your first deck? It is not an Ensnaring Bridge, Ryan. You are correct. It is not an Ensnaring Bridge. We don't have a regular stream schedule yet, but it is coming. We just streamed FNM a couple times recently. Yesterday was the first time we had a recorded stream, and that was the Standard Championships. This is our second recorded stream. We will be starting up a YouTube page and a regular stream soon. We'll be probably streaming FNMs and maybe some of our Wednesday and Thursday night events. If you're interested, just stay tuned to the channel, Four Horsemen Comics. We'll have more information in the future. You can also go on Facebook and go to Four Horsemen Comics and Gaming. Check out our Facebook page or our Facebook group, Team Four Horsemen MTG, for information on streams and also our events. If you're anywhere close to Morgantown, West Virginia, come check out what we have to offer. White and Blue. Ah, Azorius. You like your white and blue deck, Crazy Zora? I like it. It's a powerful color combination. Nutsy? Yeah, more streams are coming. I promise you that. This is something we're having a lot of fun with. We're really enjoying it. Noah and I are enjoying it. The players are enjoying it. I promise you we will be doing more streams.
Absolutely. It was exactly how we thought. Abe had watched and considered the game state rewindable.
Right.
We knew exactly what the board should have looked like. The only random aspect of what occurred was the card that Gabriel would have drawn, mm-hmm. but he wasn't in a position when he drew the card that he wouldn't been able to be casting spells.
Right.
He had proceeded with his turn. So he felt that it was minimal enough that he could reverse the game state. So that's what he did.
All right, guys, welcome to the final game. We've had a lot of positive feedback on the Twitch. They've been asking about more streams. I told them that there are more coming. Gave them information on our Facebook page.
One of us is a employee of the store.
I work here. I'm a level one judge, and I'm also the Forceman Comics tournament organizer. I am in charge of creating and running all of the Magic tournaments here at Four Horsemen. Noah is a player here and an L1 judge and a friend of the store.
Yep. I drove 3.5 hours just to come and have fun and have a blast doing this. So it was, it's awesome. It's been awesome, and I'm excited for this game. So the game's starting.
Let's settle in for our last game.
He scryed the scryed. He mulled to six, and now he's looking
Kazu
at his
has seven.
Yeah. Kazu kept to seven. He mulled to six, and now he's looking at his scry, see if he wants to tuck it or keep it.
Right. Okay. So we have Kazu on the play with a seven cards. Gabe's on the draw with six cards.
Jimmy Nuts in the stream.
Yeah, Nuts in your. I'm not going to read the rest of Jimmy's tag.
Yeah.
So that's Jimmy.
So, turn one Forest Bird, turn one Giltleaf Revealing Elvish Mystic, casting Elvish Mystic.
Okay. So, Kazu down to 19.
Very fair.
Those Lorwyn duels are really powerful.
Yeah. Very fair games of Magic. Yeah.
Green cards. We got forests. We're casting creatures. We're doing fair stuff.
You call the Lorwyn duels powerful, and they are, but there are some duds. I mean, the Elemental one. When's the last time you saw that?
I have not seen it in actual Constructed Magic.
Yeah? All right. So, Pontiff of Blight came down, killing the Elvish Mystic. And he didn't have the second land for a follow-up. That is brutal. Pontiff of Blight came down, killing the Elvish Mystic, and he didn't have the follow-up land.
Ooh.
Brutal.
That's not how I wanted to see Gabe. That's not honestly not how I wanted to see this tournament end, but hopefully Gabe can play a land and get back in this.
Brutal plays, though.
Yeah, that was hashtag savage, as our fellow judge Wyatt Gearing would say.
Yeah? Yeah, he would. Oh, jeez.
That's actually who I was talking to in the stairwell. I should have just brought him in to say it.
Yeah. What did he say?
He's leaving.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Heritage Druid is a good start.
If he draws a land, there's a whole... Oh, Collected Company. Yikes. Turn two Pontiff, turn three Collected Company.
This is not looking good for Gabe. Yeah.
Versus Seer.
There's the Seer. Does he have another combo piece?
Partial Whiff.
Okay, well, still, it's still real good.
Yeah, not the most powerful Collected Company, but still...
It's good.
A Collected Company.
He turned it into one of the combo pieces that he needs. All right, let's see what he has to follow up that. This is intense. Gabe's got to be feeling the sweat now.
Yeah.
All right, that was one of our other L1s, Mike, checking out.
Yep.
All right, so we have Kazu fetching down to 16.
Yeah, early format people will know what they want to play. Yeah, it happens. Hopefully, Gabriel will draw land here and make this final Magic game, but...
Yeah, we'd really like to see a real game here.
If he draws a land, I mean, he can just go nuts.
If he doesn't and he loses here, you know, still good on him. He played a great day of Magic.
Absolutely. Oh, no! Oh. That's the combo.
Is that it? That's the game!
That was good.
Wow.
Kazu!
Congratulations,
Negri.
Kazu Negri. Three-time West Virginia State champion.
Back-to-back
in one weekend. Taking down both the standard and the modern state championships. All right, we're gonna bring it back to the booth
here.
We
will never hear the end.
Never. But that's fine, because he earned it.
Absolutely.
We got to get him up here.
Yeah, we have to.
All
right, I can go get him.
Yeah, go go ahead. Actually, I'm going to go down with you because he's probably going to need a minute. Yep. We will be right back. Don't go anywhere, guys. We're going to have an interview with our winner, Kazu Negri, in one moment.